Just as I was starting to compose my bassoon concerto, commissioned by the American bassoonist Robert Thompson, I was told the horrific news from my native Poland about the torture and murder of the Catholic priest, Father Jerzy Popiełuszko. I was deeply shaken by this atrocity, and I immediately decided to dedicate my concerto to the memory of this Polish martyr of faith and fatherland. My bassoon concerto is composed for small string orchestra, plus flute and two clarinets. There are five contrasting movements played without a break, entitled Prologue, Recitative 1, Recitative 2, Aria and Epilogue. I gave them these operatic sounding names partly to emphasize the underlying drama of the work and partly to indicate the parlando character of the recitatives, but especially it was to point to the singing quality of the bassoon in the aria. The concerto is an abstract work with no literary program, but Father Popiełuszko was so much in my mind while I was composing that inevitably the concerto conveys some feeling of Popiełuszko's ideals and the tragedy of his death. Perhaps in Recitative 1, played by the bassoon and the three orchestral woodwind instruments, the listener might hear his humble prayer to the Virgin Mary. Possibly Recitative 2, where the bassoon is supported by the interjected chords of the string instruments, could be related to the priest's fatal encounter with the secret police, the very last interrogation before his tortured body was thrown into the Vistula River. The aria is the central and most extended part of the concerto. It is a kind of elegy for which I composed a long melodic line in the spirit and character of Polish folk song, maybe evoking Father Popiełuszko's peasant origins. The bassoon concerto could be related to some of my earlier works, in which I have expressed my feeling of compassion and of deep sorrow for all people who have suffered and lost their lives in the cause of freedom and justice.